Hey guys, I'm glad you could join me. I've been waiting for you all day because today I've got to try my first silver tip badger brush. Look at that beauty. It's massive, isn't it? Look at it. Very pleased to have got that. So I'm going to pop that in the sink very quickly. And today I'm going to be shaving with the OSP Barbershop soap, which if you've seen one of my other videos, you'll know that I love this soap. And I'm going to be shaving today with my 1928 to 1935 Old Type with the Voskhod razor blade, because I loved that the other day. Really love that. So, welcome guys, welcome to Friendship Shaving. I'm glad you're here, because now I can get started. So let's see what this wonderful brush is like. I'll tell you what, it picks up a load of water. Now, I've never ever used a silver tip before. This is a knot from the golden nib, which, amongst other things, supplies knots for shaving brushes. Just need some more water in here. This one is a 24 millimeter knot, but you can see when I held it up, it's really spread out. And I'm looking forward to using this. And it's been beautifully set into an old fuller, a vintage fuller shaving brush handle. So it's going to be a good experience today. Now the golden nib, TGN, I've been looking on the forums and they have a very good reputation for selling good quality products. And they have their own sort of grading of badger hair. And it goes from pure badger, which is the lowest they do, then finest badger, best badger, super badger, and then silver tip badger. And then above that is something called high mountain white. Now the silver badger has a couple of grades, and I've had a look online, and I think the one I've bought in this brush, because I bought it second hand, I think it's a premium knot. Oh my goodness me, look at the lather on this. Gosh. I mean, I've still got all of this in the bowl. I might just rub that on my face. Put that down there. It's exciting, isn't it? Shaving. Look at that. Right, we're ready to go, boys. Guys, massive. Look at that on my face. Now it's very, very soft. Oh, it's very soft indeed. How can I put it? It's not, look, if I do this, it kind of stays, you know, it stays in the shape of. I'm going to have add more water here. I think this is going to be a bit of a thirsty brush. Okay, this is a nice brush. I can see now why silver tips are well thought of. There's not much backbone in the brush. I think the backbone that is there is not coming from the thickness of the bristles, but more from the fact that there are so many bristles packed into this brush. That's how it feels anyway. It feels lovely. It feels really lovely. And I've had a look at the Golden Nib website today, and do you know, their knots are not as expensive as I thought they would be. This is very nice indeed. I think I'll still go with more water on here. Oh, look at that. Look at it, beautiful. Let's move that out of the way. I've just dropped my flannel, guys. Just excuse me for a second. Back. Now we'll get going with the shave. I really enjoyed the Voskhod in this razor the other day, so I'm sticking with it. Oh yeah, it's good. Now the fuller brush that I've got, can I just tell you before I say about the fuller brush, I love when I get something new, and especially when it's from a company that, you know, is an old company, and you can do a bit of research and find out about the company. I think that's really, really interesting. So the fuller brush, the fuller company was started in 1906. And they are still going today, although they don't make shaving brushes, which is rather a shame. Especially because the one I've got is so iconic. But the company was started by a Mr. Alfred Fuller, who made products in his sister's basement in Boston. And during the daytime, he went out and sold those products door to door. And in 1908, this is quite interesting, he went out with his wife. I believe her name was Evelyn. She went out as well and outsold him. And for 2 years, she outsold him every single day. That just tickles me, I don't know why. But apparently in the US, the fuller brush man is iconic. You know, in the old days, of course, the brush salesman would turn up at your door with his suitcase And the Fuller Brush Man was so iconic. He even appeared in cartoons of the day, Mickey Mouse cartoon being one of them. So that just goes to show you how iconic these salesmen were that went door to door selling Fuller brushes. Billy Graham used to be a Fuller brushman, the well-known evangelist. That's pretty interesting, eh? Do you know, I have an old photo somewhere of my father's sister, Doris. You know, back in the day. And her first husband, Alf, was a lay preacher. And I've got a picture of them somewhere, taken with Billy Graham when he visited the UK. Just as an aside. In 1923, because I've looked this up obviously, the Hartford factory in Connecticut was the biggest factory in the world at that time. All making Fuller brushes. I tell you what, it's a lovely shave with this brush and that razor today. I'm having a great shave. So I hope you've had a good shave today. The anticipation has been killing me. All day long I've waited for you boys to get here. This is a lovely brush, I have to say. I love the size of it. I love the softness of it, but it hasn't got the springiness that a very soft synthetic brush would have. You know, if I brush like that, it stays like that. And you know, if I brush the other way, it stays the other way. So I think this is a brush for, you know, well, it splays quite well. And it certainly brushes well. And I bet, look, I'll squeeze it now, but the amount of soap in here is mega. Look at that. Awesome. Now I'll just give that a quick rinse and a squeeze so you can see it in its glory. And if any of you chaps out there can help me with putting a date on this brush, I'd love to know. Look, there's the bottom. It's got this little bit of butterscotch on the bottom. This is ebonite or hardened rubber. I'd love to know about when that was made. If you have any information on that, please let me know, because I would really be interested. I didn't do a blade review today. I was going to review review the repairer blades. But of course the brush came and that took priority. The only other brush that I've got really that, well, I've got two little badger brushes, but they're both pure badger, and you can see, look at the size difference. Wow. And of course the other one is my little travel brush, which again is pure badger. In all the descriptions of the pure badger brushes, it describes them as being a coarse hair, but my two are certainly very nice. I've enjoyed using them. But of course, they're not a patch on this one, they're entirely different. I'm part of a group on Facebook that focuses on people restoring brushes. And I bought this brush for a very reasonable price from one of the chaps on there. It was, I think it was $32. Obviously I had to pay for the postage, which was another $13. And then the UK customs very kindly hit me with a customs charge. But despite all of that, I've got a wonderful, iconic American brush. You guys get all the good stuff over there. I'm going to have to move, I think. Do you know, guys, I'm heading towards 100 subscribers. Isn't that amazing? So I'm obviously doing something right with these videos. I'm not sure what it is, but if you have subscribed to my little channel, thank you very much indeed. I think the last time I looked, it was on 91. Can't believe it. Little old me getting 100 subscribers. Thanks, guys. I hope that I can make this into, you know, a real community. That's my aim. And I've got a few people that have texted me from all over the place. Alexander in Chile, a couple of guys in Russia, Michael in New York State, loads of people, it's wonderful. Just going to rinse my face off, I'll be right back, guys. Oh, that's another great shave, that is a great shave, or oh, just there, I just need to... Right there, look, that's my problem area, one of them. The hair grows that way, but only on that little bit there. And I cannot go against the grain. If I try and go against the grain, it just shreds me. I've loved that Voskhod blade in that single ring old type razor. It's given me a wonderful shave. I've been using it all week. It's absolutely terrific. And actually, I'm quite glad the brush came because I'm quite wary of doing, you know, a blade review after blade review after blade review. That would be really, really boring. So I will do more blade reviews, but I'll intersperse them with the other stuff. Love this soap. Love this soap. So today, chaps, I'm going to just put on a little bit of Lucky Tiger. I've had so much other stuff to try that I haven't used this for a little while. And I find it to be very, very soothing indeed. Love my Lucky Tiger. Oh, there we go. God, that's a good one. So there we are, chaps. That's a shave done for today. It went quite quickly today. I feel I haven't talked to you for long enough. There we are. I'm just giving my brush a quick dry so you can see it once more in its glory. Look at that, my lovely fuller brush with a golden nib, silver tip badger knot. Fantastic. That's it today, boys, from Friendship Shaving. I hope you've had a good week. I hope next week is good for you. And I'll see you again soon. You take care of yourselves now. Bye-bye.